I'm Miss Allen and I teach psychology. I've been teaching psychology on this site since 2002. But I do keep myself up to date. I'm a member of the British Psychological Society, the Association for the Teaching of Psychology, and also the Chartered College of Teaching. And what I really am interested in is development over the lifespan, from birth, especially through to early adulthood. I'm also very interested in how we learn. So what even is psychology? Psychology is the science of mind and behaviour. Psychology looks at the evidence for theories that explain why we behave in the way that we do. So psychologists do things like, yes, interviews and questionnaires and case studies and observations, but they also do experiments inside and outside the laboratory, and they use mechanical equipment to have a look at our responses and our reactions, such as MRI scans. So how do psychologists contribute to society? Well, health and clinical psychologists support us in our mental health and development and our well-being. And health psychologists sit on the government's advisory board at the moment, the SAGE, for emergencies at COVID response. And at the moment, they're advising the government on evidence that they found to help us comply with COVID regulations. They're also looking at the impact on mental health on children and adolescents of lockdown. And more recently, they're looking at the changes of behaviour as a result of vaccinations. All important stuff. Other psychologists, such as occupational psychologists, work alongside business in business to improve effectiveness, efficiency, and communication within businesses. They also work to persuade us to buy their products. Forensic psychologists look at the causes of criminal behaviour and also the methods we help criminals manage the behaviour and stop repeat offending. There are sports psychologists who focus on performance and do a lot of observation, and they may be the difference between success, that gold medal, and second place. Psychology influences our world profoundly. And it's an exciting A-level to study. So what will you be studying in A-level? In A-level, you'll be studying classic studies such as Bowlby's 44 Juvenile Thieves. What are the factors that affect their delinquency, he asks. Also, Milgram's study of obedience. What factors affect obedience in people? We study also what impact eyewitness testimony has. Can we rely on eyewitness testimony and people's memory? In psychology, we are looking at assumptions, classic studies, therapies. We're looking at the strengths and weaknesses of those therapies and also their effectiveness as approaches to explaining human behaviour. I'm asking for a B in maths, science and English, and here's why. In science, you will be planning and designing studies, investigations yourself. You're tested on two investigations in the second year, and we conduct our own research in the first year. We have to analyse the data that we create from those studies, and that's where the 10% maths comes in. You'll be writing about the assumptions that approaches make, therapies. You'll be evaluating, critically assessing those therapies and those explanations. And you'll be debating. For example, is it ethical to use conditioning techniques such as rewards and sanctions on children in school? Another question, a debate that we have, is to what extent does positive psychology contribute to our well-being and is useful and valuable to society? You have four papers, two at the end of AS. The first two papers are about past to present, that's written paper, and research methods, which is how we conduct psychological research. The second two papers in A2 are about research methods, one of them based on HUF, which is based on your own studies that you've conducted. And then the bigger paper, which is 2.5 hours long, is about the causes and treatments of stress, schizophrenia, and criminal behaviours. It's an exciting subject, which we all enjoy, and I still enjoy it after all these years. Join me. Thank you.